At today's lesson, we are going to get familiar with one of Bartók's choral pieces for equal voices, entitled Leánynéző. Say it.
Leánynéző.
Beautiful. Here you see the English and Chinese translation of the first verse. We are going to start learning the first verse. The melody starts on fa and ends on ti. Can you sing the first pitch?
Fa.
And the final pitch?
Ti.
Maybe we can tune it even a little better. Fa ti. I'm going to hum the melody for you. Please listen and sing it back with solfa. Listen to the melody again and please tap the beat on your table. Listen to it again and conduct the three pattern. Please sing it to solfa letters. Fa.
Fa, sol, mi, do, re, le, mi, do, la, sol, la, ti, do, re, mi, re, la, ti. Fa, sol, mi, do, re, le, mi, do, la, sol, la, ti, do.
Very nice. There are two specialties in this melody. The mode. Fa mi re do ti la ti do re mi fa so fa mi re do ti. What is the name of this mode that ends on ti? Locrian mode, correct. The other specialty is the 3/4 meter, which is reminds us of a dance. Zoltán Kodály points out that this is a typical rhythmic progression according to the so-called Volta dance. So dance meter, dance rhythm with Locrian scale. Let's sing it once again. Thank you. Let's look at the harmonization of this melody. We start on a C major chord. Can you sing this chord in three parts? And let me hear just the fa, fa, just the octave, and beautiful. You also see the final chord. Can we try to find the pitches of the final chord the following way? Fa, re, fa, altos. Well done. Fa, re. Sing please the C major chord. And the final. Lovely. This is a very odd, very oddly connected two chords in this form. Let's see it on the circle of fifths. What is the meaning of these two chords? The tonality, the center pitch of the chorus is a G. What function is the C? Subdominant. And how about the F sharp? Also subdominant if we describe the position of these keys on the circle of fifths and we apply the so-called axis system to the definition of these functions. Beautiful. Can you sing once again these two chords, now by memory? C major. F sharp major. C major. Lovely. On the next slide, you see the skeleton of the harmonization of this melody. You see subdominant chord moving to the dominant, arriving to the tonic. Can we sing these three chords? Careful with the change here. And next one will be re, la, fi, subdominant, dominant, tonic. Dominant, tonic. Beautiful. This is the skeleton, the harmonic skeleton of this phrase. But now let's sing the whole thing as set by Bartók. Can we sing now from your music the whole first section? Hold up your music.
Mm-hmm.
All right. The second phrase of the first verse resembles a lot to the opening phrase, only the harmonization is a little different. Can you sing the cadence of the opening phrase? Mi, do, and. And sing now the cadence of the closing phrase. Mi, do. That's it. Let's sing now from the beginning. Rui Ivan Shimin, please stand and sing the beginning with solfa. Thank you very much. Have a seat. There are two motives in the first section, which is developed in an organic way in the second part of the composition. Fa, fa, so, mi, do is the first one. Can you sing it? And the second motif? Mi. That's it. I'm going to play the subject of the second section. Please identify how many times you hear a melodic turn, which is similar to this one, and how many times you hear a melodic turn, which is similar to this one. Zianan, how many times did you hear this phrase? Two times, very nice. Itau, how many times did you hear a melodic turn which was similar to this one? Only once. Very good. Can you now listen to it again and try to sing it back with solfa? What is the last pitch, Haixin? Very good. What is the first pitch? Who will sing it? Yinglin? Beautiful. Xiongrong, could you please also sing it, and then everyone else try to imagine it with letter names. If is this Xiongrong.
La la ti si mi so so.
let's sing it to letter name, shall we? If you look at the second part, you will see similar motifs occurring. Beautiful. Zunan and Caillou, could you please sing these two parts? Thank you very much. This ending is quite difficult to tune. Can you sing once more just the ending? Re, si, and. Better. Thank you very much. Everyone together, have a seat.
La.
Lovely. Let's add now the top part, which also has similarities when compared to the opening melody. Can I hear it in three parts? Please stand.
Long.
Thank you. Have a seat. The most exciting part of this section is when finally the meter changes. After this dance-like progression, we have something little longer. And also you see how Bartók sets this section chromatically, describing the text, which reads, "Don't let yourself be seduced by the honeyed words of the girl. Don't let her seduce you." Yeah. Let's practice these chromatic parts. Mezzo, alto. And now together in three parts. Only girls. Thank you, tutti. And finally, we will move on to the last section of the composition. In this section, Bartók repeats the six measure phrase here with a changed alto line, changed alto and mezzo line. Can we sing this section? Fa, fa, la. Now only the soprano and the mezzo. Now please listen to the recording and identify the missing alto line. And once again. What is the final note? Can you show the melodic contour of this alto line? Show the melodic contour and hum. Beautiful. Let's sing the piece from the beginning.